Good morning. I know it's early and we're live. I am starting a new book. I kind of wanted to show you a little bit about how I go about doing research. This one's going to be very research intensive. We got to learn a little bit about the Great Depression and employment during a very difficult period in history, which, as we know, isn't always easy to discuss or research. So I thought I'd take a few minutes, probably about 30 minutes. It's NaNoWriMo. I'm sure many of you have already done your research and prepped for this month. The only problem that I've got right now is that I haven't been able to get the browser set up properly so I can show you the actual research, but I can show you where I'm taking my notes and how I'm organizing those notes. In this case, one of the first things that you'll find I search for me, is the most specific thing I can think of. So, let's see. We want employment during the Depression, during the Great Depression, there have been many cyclic things. Employment during the Great Depression on Long Island, New York. Now, Long Island, in this case, is the setting for this story. What I'm expecting to find is a lot of historical papers, a lot of references. I don't expect to find too many first-hand accounts at this point, although they should exist and they should be available. Getting suggested books, of course. And books are great, but we all know when we're trying to organize our history and organize what we need, we're only going to stop and read those books when we have a moment. We're trying to go forward and complete our draft. I have found that I will continue to do research. So if I find that I wrote in my draft an error, I will correct it. I may pick up one of the books that are being suggested for that reason. Here's a good reference, the New York Times and its jobs during the Great Depression. This was actually released in 1974. The archive is a digital version of the Times from that era. They quote Franklin Roosevelt 40 years before, so during the Great Depression. Let's see. He had urged a community improvement corps to go into effect after the unemployment rate reached 6%. This would be important to kind of do more research on. And the biggest reason why, in my case, I would want to do more research on this is because it gives me a starting point for the jobs my main characters are actually two young women in this story, and one of their fathers had to get employment during this time. Now for me, I also try to record the information source. I won't necessarily link to it because it's not going to actually be I write fiction, I don't write nonfiction. If I were writing nonfiction, I would put a link to this source so that I could come back to it. Because you always want to verify the information when you're writing nonfiction. With fiction, you've got a little bit of wiggle room, but you need the essence of what you're saying. You don't want to just put stuff out there. When you're writing nonfiction, your reputation, your brand, whether you're a ghostwriter or a prolific writer, an author yourself, your brand depends on your facts. In my case, my brand depends on my believability and the ability to suspend belief. So if I'm writing in this context, the settings are going to be a little different than what I usually work with. But if I'm writing a contemporary setting or I'm writing a historical setting, I need to be believable on some level. This is why I do this research. It's important when you're doing this kind of research to ensure that you are providing good information for your readers. So sorry, it's so early in the morning. This is the quietest time, and this really is when I do my research and my writing. I am not even sure if I'm live. So this may end up being uploaded as a recording. I will leave it unedited and raw because it was intended to be alive. Everything on my end says I'm fully connected and everything looks good. I even have a visitor. It'd be incredibly helpful if you're popping in if you would just say hi so that I know that this is live and working. However, I am not sure why it says I'm going live at 7. I'm very confused. Anyway, like I said, I will go ahead and upload this as a regular video when I am done. Just gonna do a couple more since it doesn't look like, for some reason, I seem to be live. Okay, so we've got this newspaper from the New York Times, and if I close it, I won't be able to come back to it because the New York Times says you only get one a month. So let's look for a jobs report for 20, I'm sorry, for 1930. Labor force and unemployment. Let's see, it's a. Okay, that's a government source. I wish I could show you the browser. That would really be helpful in this video. I am going to have to pick someone's brain on how to make that work effectively. When I set up the browser, all it gave me was a black screen, and I could go back to the notes, but I couldn't go to the browser, which was not helpful. Okay, in this case, I am not going to be able to copy and paste from the PDF, however. I will make sure that I type in what I need. The jobs reports typically indicate where jobs are lost at, and okay, that's typically indicate today. Obviously, I don't know whether when that began. Looks like the total civilian labor force in 1929 was 49,180 able-bodied individuals. I'm guessing there were few accounting of women during that time, although don't hold me to that. As I wasn't there, obviously, and I'm still trying to find that information. This shows unemployment rate in 1929 really wasn't that bad. It looks like it peaked in 1933. three. And then declined after that. Let's see, 33. Is that right? Yeah, that's right. Then it went on the decline. We had a slight resurgence in 1938, where it increased again. But by 1939, it went on a steady decline. Excuse me. And of course, in 1944, it was at its best, if you will, during this decade and a half that this particular report covers. And it seems the greatest employment was in agriculture and, of course, the military. This is very important for my book, so I'm going to include greatest unemployment year was 1933. Greatest employment year during. Now it's kind of funny because this particular report covers the decade and plus that I'm writing about in this book, so it's good information to have. I'm so sorry, excuse me. Decade. No one said I had to spell confidently at 6 o'clock in the morning. The greatest employment year during this decade was 1944. Which is a pivotal year in my character's life. One of my character's lives. At that point, she's getting to be employment age. So she's got a lot of decisions to make. And I'd already settled on 1944 because of all other reasons for this character. Really, I guess she makes a lot of her big decisions in 1943, but there are things that are a little bit more challenging that, of course, come up as big decisions are made, globally speaking. In this case, I am keeping this as unemployment report spanning 1929 to 1945, and that's just in case there's more data that I can glean out of that I can't get on a quick live or quick video. Now I'm going to be doing things like this over the next little bit this month, because organizing your notes, this is not the full organization for my notes. This is your start. This is where you begin to gather your data, put it all together. In my case, I'm not going to need to go back to the New York Times article. I've taken the part that's going to help me reading the Congressional and Community Improvement Corps, looking at the what they called it. Now, we've always heard that they began to hire people, the government began to hire people to move bricks and make roads and build out the landscape and or the infrastructure. And these projects were pivotal and crucial in improving the overall employment. I'm dealing with one family, but I expect that this one family is affected by a lot of these things in order to survive efficiently. There are certain things that I need these characters to be able to maintain, that I need these characters to be able to ensure are okay. So this is the kind of thing that I would look up. I am looking forward to, I'm going to complete this research this morning. And what's going to happen here is that I'm going to do all the general big research. In this case, I'm looking at I'm going to look up more of that about the Congressional Community Improvement course and what that entailed exactly, because now I have something to search. I'm also going to look up what years the Community Improvement course coincided with this unemployment report to make sure that it overlaps. And then I'm going to look specifically at New York, because that's where my characters are going to be at. And in New York, there's a wealth of history and a plethora of information. So I will go through a lot of that to determine if the things that I'm looking for are there. And then I've got another advantage. I have had the opportunity to speak with family who actually lived through it in New York. Although it's been a lot of years since we've discussed it, I do have some memories to draw on as well. Really find that if you can interview a person when you're dealing with a historical piece, if you can interview a person who's lived through this, whatever era you're working with, that's always going to be your best option. Always. Okay, so this is basically how I do my research. I wish I could have shown you the browser. I will get that fixed, and I will do another research one later. And then I will show you how I do the browser. But basically, I do things that are very, very specific. One of the searches that I'm going to be doing are things like New York employment, because obviously I want my character to be employed. In this case, we know that the worst year was in 1933, so I'm going to go like that. The other thing I'm going to do Okay, no, I did not say I spelled right. I love spell check. New York agriculture in 1933. And of course, you know, that agriculture at the time was the biggest employable market. So that's why we're going to do that. And before anybody wonders, New York, the state, is huge. It is not just Buffalo or New York City with the five boroughs and the city and the tower, the stuff going on there. New York has got mountains and farms and beautiful, beautiful scenery. And it is one of the nicest, complete states when you give it a chance. Because you can go from the hustle and bustle and energy, which I love, of a city, and you can go out into the country and enjoy the beautiful farms, and you can enjoy the interaction, and it's really, really, really lovely. So I picked New York for this setting because of the versatility and the options that are available. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. I will make sure I come and answer them. On the next one, I will show you how I organize this for quick reference before I actually start writing, and that will probably be either later today or more likely it'll be tomorrow. Like I said, I'm going to upload this even if it's a video. There isn't much that you see to it, so I hope my conversation, my idle chattering, has been helpful. Have a good day. See you later.